In this class of Business Environment and Ethical Practices, we'll be talking about business ethics and relevance of ethics and values in business. First of all, let's have a look at what are business ethics and why does it matter. Business ethics are basically ethical solutions to business and organizational problems. And that may have more than one right alternative, and sometimes no right solution may seem available. Business ethics, if we have to give a definition, we can define it as the study of how personal moral norms apply to the activities and goals of commercial enterprises, as dealing with three basic areas of managerial decision making. First one being opinion about what the laws should be and whether to follow them or not. Second, choices about economic and social issues outside the domain of law. And third, choices about the priority of self-interest over the company's interest. So we are taking into consideration the individual and organizational ethics both. And the idea is to develop or to see a relationship between the individual morals or the societal morals and how these morals or ethics are being utilized in a business setting. And it is quite important, which we'll discuss in the following slides also, it is quite important for a business to be ethical in nature. Although practically at times, business also crosses certain lines and does something which might not be ethical in nature, but the degree has to be checked and it has to be ensured that no business is going into is operating in an unethical manner. Why does ethics matter? First, doing the right thing matters to employers, stakeholders, and the general public. Like for instance, if we look at certain recent cases, Nestle had to withdraw Maggie from the market. Johnson & Johnson faced heat from the media, public, society over its baby powder product. Recently, HUL has stopped using the word fair in its very famous brand, Fair and Lovely. Because these things are connected with the society and it matters a lot. And it not only matters to the company only, it matters to everybody who is directly or indirectly associated, be it employee, stakeholder, and the public. If going to an unethical path, it can also mean for certain companies that they might have to invest or spend so much money in fighting lawsuits and everything like what is happening with Google and Facebook all over the world over data protection. So for companies, being ethical means saving millions and billions of dollars each year in lawsuits, settlements, and that. Like we have seen certain number of cases in tobacco industry wherein the companies were fined with hefty amounts for their unethical behavior. Issues related with child labor are emerges all over the world. And in the past, we have seen some major cases wherein the companies were penalized for using child labor. Then other cost which the business might have to bear if they are not ethical are deterioration of relationship. No doubt, relationships may become bad for business organization, and since the business runs on relationship only, so it can be a big dent for the company. It damages the reputation also. Any company which is unethical in its conduct is bound to earn some bad reputation, which is very, very harmful for any business organization. It also results in declining employee productivity, creativity, and loyalty. Undoubtedly, if a company is not handling its customers in an ethical way, it will not be able to handle its employees as well in the ethical way, and which will directly impact the productivity of the employee, their creativity, their loyalty, their ability to take initiative and whatnot. ineffective information flow throughout the organization. If the systems are not well built, structures are not followed, and the company, it doesn't look at ethics as a vital part element of the organization, then ineffective information or the wrong informations will flow throughout the organization, and informal groups might take the driving seats, which is again a big threat for any organization. Absenteeism is generally seen because if from the employee side, undoubtedly, if the employees are not happy, satisfied with the way they are being handled or with the way the organization is running, absenteeism can be a good and a bad effect which the company might have to see. Levels of business ethics. Because ethical problems are not only an individual or personal matter, it is helpful to see the different levels at which issues originate and how they move to other levels. There are 5 levels in business ethics. First is individual, like how, what is right or wrong for an individual. Second, the organizational, like what the organization believes is right or wrong. Third, association. If the company is a part of association, if like how together the entire industry moves towards business ethics and or what they believe is right and wrong. For example, advertisements have always been criticized for exaggerating the products or using women as a sex object, or there are n number of things. But there are companies which believe that it is okay because the interpretation of the advertisement depends upon the individual who is watching it. So their logic is it totally depends upon who is watching it, but the certain volunteers or groups are against this kind of advertising because they believe it undoubtedly gives a bad message. Then societal ethics, what the society believe is good or bad, it also matters. And last but not the least is international ethics. Like when a thing travels from one place to another, how it is being taken there. So all these 5 levels must be counted well, because ethical issues can emerge at any level and it must be dealt in such a way that the entire structure or the working of the organization is not impacted. And even if it is, the degree of impact must be the lowest possible. Ethical reasoning in business is at least required for these 3 reasons. First, many times laws are insufficient and do not cover all aspects or gray areas of a problem. So there might be certain areas wherein, like I just talked about advertising. Now nobody can draw a very specific line as to what is right and what is wrong. But the business or the organization must be ethical in its conduct with respect to the content that they are developing and showcasing in their advertisements. Free market and regulated market mechanism do not effectively inform owners and managers about how to respond to complex issues and crises that have far-reaching ethical consequences. So at times, business organizations are more concerned about their own stakes, and the market mechanism might not be able to draw a perfect line between good and bad. So their ethical reasoning is required. And last but not the least, complex moral problems requires an intuitive or learned understanding and concern for fairness, justice, and due process to people, groups, and communities. And only if ethical reasoning is being utilized there, is being used there, only then the company will be able to resolve the issues in a good way. Importance of ethics, and this part of this presentation, like importance of ethics, we can utilize it at individual and organizational level both. First, satisfying basic human needs. Being fair, honest, and ethical is one of the basic human needs. Although it sounds a bit theoretical, but this is a fact. Then creating credibility. An organization that is believed to be driven by moral values is respected in the society, even by those who may have no information about the working and the business or the or an organization. Like in India, if I may quote, Tatas are considered to be very ethical. So they have earned that kind of reputation, and which undoubtedly helps them in the market. Then uniting people and leadership. Any organization driven by values is revered by its employees. And it is revered or respected by people outside the organization as well. It helps in improving decision-making also. A man's destiny is the sum total of all the decisions that he or she takes in course of his or her life. Although this is, again, a school of thought, but this is how we think. This is how we work. So decisions are driven by values. And these values can play a vital role in understanding or determining the conduct of any business organization. If any organization wants to achieve long-term gains, then it has to be guided by ethics and values. Because only proper ethical and value-based conduct can lead the organization towards a big success. And any business organization is nothing without society. So societal element must also be taken care of. And securing the society is basically, it requires ethics for sure. Thank you.